sorry. Yeah, looks like it's doing that. I thought it might have been my spectacles. Apparently not. I thought I had my hair cut. Now it's showing the anomalies in my head. No. Anyway, forget about that. I've got some glue in the back room. I shall sort that out a bit later. I'm going to show you very, very quickly how to play a brilliant Tom Petty song called Free Falling. Here it is here. Now take a screenshot of this. It's not in depth, so I'm not going to bother putting it up on a link or anything. It's easy to do. So grab a screenshot of that. Okay, boink. 1, 2, 3, 4, bump. There you go. There's only a few chords in it. We've got a D, like this, in the traditional D way. Capo at the 3rd fret, all right? I'm playing it on the 12 string because it's nice and jingly jangly, and he uses one. If you play it on a 6 string, that's fine. It'll still sound great. If it's a 6 string electric, you know, electroacoustic, put a little bit of chorus on it as well. A little tiny bit of chorus and a bit of reverb. Similarly with electric, and you'll get that sort of 12 string effect. All right, so D played like this, all right? Now, it's very important that we keep fingers 1 and 3 on these strings throughout the whole song. I'll explain why. When we come to play our next chord, which is a G, keep this one here and this one there, 1 and 3, and bring your second finger up to the bass note. Allow it to lie across the 5th, because we want to mute that. And put your little finger on the 1st string at the 3rd fret. So we've got this. Anyway, let me give you a quick example. We've got the D, we've brought this finger up to there for the G, and we've put a little finger there. We strike the G again, we go back to the D, and then for the final chord, which is an A sus 4, we take this finger, finger number 2, and we bring it up and put it on top of finger number 1. And if we do it that way rather than move 2 fingers, it means that these notes can continue to ring out throughout the whole piece. And that's what you want. You're looking for that sort of drone effect. Now, look down to the bottom of this. This is the rhythm here over 2 bars. Can you see it? 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. And above the beats and the half beats, I've put the chords that we need to play. And you'll see that some of them land on the ands, the half beats. So we've got 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. And that's where our chords will sit. Now, in order to get the accents, which basically means play it a bit louder, we've got to be careful we don't start off too loud. Otherwise, we've reached the threshold and we've got nowhere to go. So imagine we've got 1 to 10 on our volume control. We want to be playing on guitar at around 4. Okay? So I'll use the D just to get going. So 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. And that gives me plenty of threshold now to whack it up when I want to give it a thump. So we want to go 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. Because we're doing all downstrokes and we're not striking the strings on the way up, we have the means then to sort of make it sound even busier by doing this. But your hand movement, if I was to turn the volume off and you watch my hand, it looks like I'm doing the same thing. Indeed, the movement of the hand is the same. I'm just catching the strings on the way up when I want it to sound fuller. And if we're a solo guitar player doing a gig, the dynamics is really important because we are the band, all right? Well, I'm gonna put Petty on, Mr. Petty, and I'll play along and you can see what I mean. G, Now, what happens after that? I can hear you all asking. Nothing. You just keep going and going and going and going until it stops. If you don't believe me, capo third fret, do what I've just said, screenshot this, play along to Tom Petty, all right? And if you were doing a gig on Saturday, you could actually be playing that song, as long as you can find somebody to sing it. All right, so there's your little lesson for today. I'll try and think of some more 12-string stuff to do. Any suggestions, let me know. What else was I going to do? I don't know. Subscribe if you haven't already done so, and press that little bell thing or whatever it is to let you know that I've put a new video up. All right, I will catch you next time. Look after yourselves. Bye-bye.